There's an overview here of Dingling. We just crossed through the ticket gate there. Joint burial tomb, 13th Ming Emperor, Zhu Yijun, 1563-1620 is two empresses, Empress Xiao Duan, is that right? And Empress Xiao Jing? Xiao Duan?
Xiao Duan.
It is also the first imperial tomb excavated in a scientific way with approval of the State Council of China. Construction of Dingling started 1584, ended 1590, and was built with choice materials and in large scale, although more than 400 years have elapsed since their completion. Seoul Tower, the Baocheng? Baocheng?
Baocheng.
How do you say Bo or Bao?
Baocheng.
And tomb gates still stand intact today. More than 3,000 pieces of relics unearthed from the tomb include a golden crown and phoenix coronet, and have provided a rich variety of materials and scientific basis for the study of politics, economy, and culture of the Ming. And if you'll speak Russian, do they have, no, they don't have any Russian?
No.
All right, well, we're in, so I'll be happy if we get to see these two and not Zhao Ling, because it didn't seem like it was all that much, but it's included in the through ticket. It's Zhao Ling's right here too. It's from the same car park, I think, here. You know, I hate those groups. Like, you get good value for your money because they'll take you to like so many sites and explain it and walk you in, and it's easy, but you don't have time to like read any of it. It's like a tease. So this is all a repeat of what we did in our last video, 1409 and 1644, when the Ming Dynasty falls to the Manchus and the Qing Dynasty takes over. 13 imperial tombs, 7 concubine tombs, and a eunuch's tomb scattered in the valley. I wonder who the eunuch's tomb is. Zhang He? Zhang He?
It surprised me they have a eunuch tomb here.
The eunuchs had a lot of power.
Yeah, in the palace.
Yeah. They were the power behind everything. So we first took the bus up to here, and then over to here. The train station's down here. So on the way out, we'll take the bus down to here and then walk the few kilometers through here. We gotta check when the last train is, so we don't miss the last train home or the last bus. Because I would like to walk the Sacred Way if there's time. Let's see, Dingling is located at the eastern foot of the Daiyu Mountains. Dingling is the joint burial tomb of the 13th Ming Emperor. There's two empresses. His title reign was Wan Li. Posthumous title was Shen Zhang. He ascended the throne at the age of 10 and ruled for 48 years until he died at the age of 58. It took 6 years to build Dingling, construction of which started in November of 1584 and ended in June of 1590. Dingling covers an area of 180,000 square meters. The underground palace of Dingling is the only one of the Ming tombs excavated so far. With the approval of the State Council, trial excavation started in May of 1956 and finished 1 year later, with a total floor space of 1,195 square meters. The underground palace is composed of 5 stone chambers, the front chamber, the middle chamber, the rear chamber, and the left and right annex chambers. More than 3,000 pieces of cultural relics were unearthed from Dingling. In 1959, Dingling Museum was set up at the original site and opened to the public. So essentially what he's showing you here on the map, that tour guide's got his fucking flag in the way. But essentially you have a central axis with the front gate a middle gate, a central hall, and then behind it is the spirit tower, and he's pointing up there to the burial mound. That's the spirit tower he's pointing at now. Do not portray. They don't want us to walk up this way. We gotta walk around, I guess. So this would have been the way processions went, but we have to go around, I guess. No? No, we can go up here. The foundation of Ling En Gate. Single eave saddle roof, 1644, burnt down by the peasants uprising. Army led by Li Jicheng. From the 50th to 52nd year of the reign of Emperor Qianlong of the Qing, it was reconstructed in contracted scale. It was destroyed once again during the Republic of China. Only foundation remains today. So they say that it's much less impressive to walk through this complex than it is to go through Qianling. Because it's been ruined, most recently by the Red Guard during the Cultural Revolution, when the idea was to get rid of everything old. Get rid of old customs, old thoughts, and old religion. Toilets are over here to your left. That's where the tour group's headed. I really hate tour groups coming through with loudspeakers. They come into the museums with those loudspeakers. I've seen them doing it in the gardens at Suzhou, a UNESCO World Heritage Site, and here comes a tour group with loudspeakers. Cloud and mountain. This one looks like it's got unusually a dragon and phoenix or crane. I don't know if that's a phoenix or crane. Mountain cloud, dragon, phoenix, crane. Usually it's a phoenix and dragon symbolizing emperor and empress, yin yang.
No.
So I don't think it takes all that long to walk through the complex here. But what you really want to do is get down into the tombs. Which I'm hoping they don't close right at 4 o'clock. Ruins of Ling En Hall. Sacrificial ceremonies to enshrine and worship the memorial tablets, hats, and clothes of the dead. Originally built grand scale, 7 bays wide, 5 deep. Double eaves looking magnificent, 17th year of Chongzhen, burned by peasants uprising, troops led by Li Jicheng, later Duo Ergun, Prince Rui of the Qing Dynasty, broke through the Shanhai Guam Pass and demolished it. During the 50th and 52nd years of Emperor Qianlong's reign, it was reconstructed in a much smaller scale, 5 bay wide, 3 bay deep. The hall that we were at earlier at the Qianling had to be about 9 bays wide, so much bigger by comparison. I never know what they mean by bays, because sometimes it's hard to tell from the facade. Stone ram carved with dragon and phoenix. Yes, it's a phoenix, not a crane. I think the phoenix that they show in a lot of Chinese art is based on the peacock. Lingxin Gate with tops of the pillars in it rises up into the sky, symbolizes the dignity and imperial system in an ancient building, just like the heavenly gate of the celestial palace. I think I can put my umbrella away if the glare stops anyway through the trees. I've lost Ting Ting. There she is. I like their little seats with elephants. That's kind of cool. It's have a seat on an elephant, terrestrial bones. Toilets are to the left and right, I guess, or what is in there, an exhibit? Looks like an exhibit hall. Oh no, the tour group's going in. Let me beat them. Ha ha ha, fuck you, I win. Preface. Now I was here first, and they can wait. Dingling Mausoleum. 180,000 square meters, 6 years, 8 million liang, unit of weight, is silver. Excavation underground palace started, blah, blah, blah. It's all a repeat. Here's a nice map that shows you what it looks like to go down the sacred way up towards the mountains. And then most of the, really all of the, from Siling over to Daling, are in a arc following the perimeter of the mountains. Located at the foot of Tianqi Mountain, northern part of Qingping District, Beijing. 80 square kilometers. Gold crown hat. Original appearance map. So it would have been, we would be about here. That's a spirit tower and mound for burial. He died at 58. Buried the same year. His first wife, surnamed Wang, Empress Xiaoduan, born in Yuyao, Zhejiang province, daughter of an official named Wang Wei. She was conferred the title Empress, 1578, died 1620, buried in Dingling, same year, in October. Empress Xiaojing, surnamed Wang, mother of Guangzhong. Born in Xuan region, January 1565, daughter of an official named Wang Chao Kai, conferred the title of concubine, promoted as imperial concubine, April 34th year, Wan Li reign, died September 39th year of Wan Li reign, buried cemetery on the left of the east well of Tianchu Mountain. When her grandson, Shi Zhang, ascended the throne, she was promoted to the rank of Empress Dowager. Then her body was moved and buried in Dingling, October 3rd, 1620, first year of Tai Chang reign. What's up with October 3rd? I guess that's the year that he was buried, Wan Li. So they followed suit, huh? Gold flagon. Flagon. Gold jar with insights, clouds, and dragon. Gold basin. Jade pendants with dragon and cloud traced in gold. Gold basin, Wan Li reign, Ming Dynasty, incised dragon design. Jade belt. It's a leather belt. Embedded jade. Jade paperweight. With a gold inscription, gold inlay. And a wooden box, silver goblet. Silver bowl, gilded silver plate. Gilded silver ladle and bronze mirror. Bronze mirror, back. Gilded silver hairpin embedded with gems and pearls, Chinese characters for 10,000 years, jubilation. hairpins, gilded silver hairpin embedded with gems and pearls and Chinese characters, 10,000 years jubilation. Blue and white porcelain, Mei Ping. Rouge box and bowl. Here's a big seal. Empress Xiao Jing, posthumous title. There's the imprint. Gold coins with caption reading, averting disaster and prolonging life. These are ceremonial. Wan Li Tong Bao. Tong Bo. Booklet. Jade bowl, gold lid. Dragon robe, armor. Lacquered plates, riveted together, it looks like. Sewn, these are brass or bronze. Sewn on. Cotton padding, it looks like. Helmets, sword, there's the dragon robe. Only the emperor can wear imperial yellow. It's my Puyi impression. Yellow kisi, ceremonial robe, 12 applique and characters for luck and longevity. Bats for luck, fu, right? Gauze material with gold thread and patterns of running rabbits. Notice the swastika. Sanskrit. Came over the Silk Road. Some of that symbolism. Clothes embroidered with 100 children. Some stone epitaphs. Here's a helmet. Phoenix and cloud. Dragons on top. Lots of pearls. Diamonds and pearls. Phoenix. Coronet with 9 dragons and 9 phoenixes, that was. Here's the last bit, what it would have looked like to see the spirit tower. And then the burial mounds behind the spirit tower. That's the real attraction of this one. Some video taken probably when they excavated in the 50s, I guess. This is what they found. There was water damage to the chamber. The chamber was improperly sealed. So a lot of the artifacts were damaged by water. Excavation site, second exploratory trench. That's never good. Exploratory trench. Direction stone tablet. Conclusion, successful excavation. Well, I guess they had no choice but to just make a big open pit and dig. Here's an aerial view of Dingling. As you can see, there's no central hall, no fore hall. All destroyed. Just a spirit tower. I don't know if there's something across the way there. Yeah. So it's the same layout as the other one, except there was no big wall. Oh, that's the start of the Spirit Tower. Okay. There's the ceremonial stone incense offering. Guess there's more exhibit over here. The way you light up my life like nobody else. Need some water. Boom, 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 boom. Gold jar with handle. Gold basin. The Golden Bowl. Remember that movie? That was an ivory, what's that film company? Golden Wares, Uma Thurman, Wears Her Breasts. There are 289 pieces of golden wares unearthed in Ding Ling. Most of them were wares for everyday use in the Imperial Palace, falling into 25 categories, including basin plate, wine cup, kettle, jar, etc. These gold wares are exquisitely made and of high craftsmanship. Gold soap box, gold powder box, and I don't know if you're pouring water or maybe tea. They say gold doesn't tarnish, but that one's got a green patina. Might just be the reflection that's tarnished, huh? Looks like it's maybe plate over silver or brass, gold plate. Here's some of the jade again. Jade by, jade paperweight, jade belt. 10 jade belts were unearthed. Most of them were made from the best white tallow jade and green jade. Jade pendants. Unreplaceable ornaments of imperial crowns and robes in ancient times, linked with jade jewelries of different sizes. Pendants were attached to the left or right of one's belt. They let out clear and crisp sound when walking, demonstrating magnanimousness and elegance of emperors and empresses. Unearthed at Ding Ling were 7 sets of 14 pendants, which are white in color, vivid, and of exclusive and exquisite design. Here is dragon. Same thing on the back. A nice robe. With bunny rabbits or hares. Women's line jacket or brocade with gold thread and green gauze with patterns of winding flowers. Embroidered square patch means longevity. And a square neck band, originally unearthed at Empress Xiao Jing's coffin. Patch on the front, embroidered with 2 rabbits holding lucid ganodermas in their mouths. Each lucid ganoderma supports a character, meaning longevity, on the top. On each side of the patches, decorated with a rising dragon playing with pearl. Upper part of the dragon's head is embroidered with character, meaning 10,000. Oh yeah, the flowers go into these characters, don't they? It's got a square collar. Is that scissors? Candle holders. Miniature tin burial objects, copper tin. Inscriptions in ink to indicate their names. They were labeled, huh? Important material for studying forms and standards, the utensils used in the Ming Imperial court. Washabti. They look like washabti from Egyptian tombs, don't they? Wooden figurines. Used to be one of the burial objects in ancient times. Figurines are usually made of wood, pottery, or carved stone. Unearthed from Ding Ling, all wooden figurines in shapes of humans and horses. Tourists back in the day, loving it up.
There's a dragon.
Whole piece of silk robe, material with clouds and dragon design and gold thread. On yellow background of gourds, strung with rattan. Satin with lotus design.
We got some stuff there for sale, books mostly. The way you light up my life like nobody else.
Silver and gold ingots.
And that's the jade. Guess I'll go out the exit. Though it's not crowded enough to really matter. I lost my friend here. I was waving to her from the gate there, but then I ran in to get ahead of the tour group.
I think she was trying to call about the last train to see when the last train is.
I don't know where she went. The way you light up my life like nobody else.
Finds 5 stone sacrificial vessels, symbolic sacrificial utensils, 1 incense burner, 2 candlesticks, and 2 vases. Placed on sacrificial altar, decorative articles are designed to create a commemorative atmosphere at the tomb. So these are modern. I guess they would have had originally porcelain bronze stuff. All right, let's see if we can get into the actual tomb chamber. They didn't close it. No inflammables. There's a security check, huh?
The way you light up my life like nobody else. Oy. So I guess you go into the Spirit Tower on the way out.
Tunnel gate and brick tunnel, situated beneath the wall of Bochang on the right of the Soul Tower. Tunnel gate was discovered because parts of the ladder brick collapsed. It was the first clue found during the excavation. Archaeologists thus dug the first exploration dish at the corresponding position in Bochang, discovering the brick tunnel and the stone slab with the inscriptions tunnel gate inside the wall. After that, another 2 exploration ditches were dug, and then the stone slab with the 16 characters engraved on it, 16 jang further and 3.5 jang deep to the diamond wall. 1 jang equals 3.33 meters. And stone tunnel built with porphyry were discovered in succession. Finally, the diamond wall was found at the end of the stone tunnel.
Alrighty. The way you light up my life.
Where was that playing? Last night, I think it was on Nanlu Gu, inside one of the clubs. Now it's in my brain. Ugh. It's rotting my neurons as we speak, corrupting all the information I get from China with Western pop music. Question. Which one of the following is an example of cultural diffusion? A. Teenagers listening to rock music in Red Square. B. Thunderstorm weather. Do not use mobile phone. They have those signs everywhere here.
But all the ruins. Here's the brickwork. This summer, when I went back to Dublin for the historic week at the end of August, they had I went up to Newgrange and saw the Neolithic tombs, which are mounds that were built, graded with levels of soil and earth, surrounded by a ring of stone. The Underground Palace. It took 2 years to build the Underground Palace, 12th year Wanli, 1584, to the 14th year of the Wanli, 1586. The layout is similar to that of the Imperial Palace of the Ming Dynasty, consisting of five halls, the front of the hall, the middle hall, the rear hall, the left and right halls. The roofs are in the shape of two intersecting arcs. There are exquisitely carved stone gates between the chambers. The coffins of the emperor and empress and the funerary objects are placed in the rear hall. In front of the hall, there is a brick tunnel for the burial of the emperor and the empress. The empresses, empress and empress dowager. During the excavations of 56-57, it was partially cleared, but the exposed part is still available for visitors. Outside the left and right halls, there are stone slabs carved with left passage, right passage, but they were not excavated so far. Does it really count that you were an emperor if you were made an emperor after you died? I don't think it counts. If you didn't actually get to live the life. So we gotta go through security here.